This is Emmie with PDX Paranormal. I'm here with Patty from the G Team, Heather and Greg's Hauntings. Also, we call her Margaret. No, I'm joking. It's not Margaret. Oh my God, I actually forgot your name.
Karen.
Oh my God. And then we got Rebecca from Rebecca's Realm. And here we are. We're at the Shiloh Cemetery. I don't know if this is backwards, but yeah. Let's have some fun. There's Heather and Greg.
Look at her setup.
Look at her setup.
She has the equipment. Like, she has more equipment than me and my mom put together. Like, she's
got it
going.
I am ready.
She is ready. And what's your channel name?
PDX Paranormal.
Get over to her channel, guys, as well. Check it out. These two ladies have been great friends of my mom for quite some time. And we appreciate that. She needs all the love that she can get.
Oh yeah.
From the loyal people, though. The loyal people.
The friends. Always. The true friends.
I don't know what loyalty is.
I think this is cool how...
But you know what?
Yeah.
I do. See? It's on my arm. When you love somebody...
You got it.
You just be loyal, regardless.
Right? Well, you just be loyal in life, period.
In life. Period. That's what you do. That's what we do.
Crunchy.
Some people don't know about loyalty. Unfortunately.
I'm sorry, those are shells. I thought those were stones.
No, they're shell, like, because they're durable.
Oh.
You notice some of these don't even have a mark on them.
Yeah.
They think this is a...
Oh, look at those conches.
Okay? Massacre. Definitely would like to do a spirit box session right here.
Look at
she's
her.
Drawn to this area. So, tonight, we're going to pull out the S-70, and we're going to try to communicate.
Oh, look at this. No, it's not.
It's sad. Look at all these unmarked graves.
Right?
Yeah, there's a lot of them.
I know. A lot of them are children, too.
Oh.
Yeah, it's really sad. Like, there's an unknown child back there. But it's sad to see that.
Heartbreaking.
Oh, my gosh. Look at all this, you guys. When was the cemetery? 1800s, right?
Yeah, from the 1800s.
Look at all these. Oh, these are, you can tell those are babies right there.
No.
Oh.
No.
And guess who I got with me?
Hello.
It's Patty. From the G Team, go and check her out. Even though she sends people to my channel. Look at all these babies. Oh my gosh.
Alright, I'm going to get my light on. I know I'm going to need it soon.
I'm gonna put this on airplane mode. And couple cameras going here. One's my phone. Patty's getting all set up. Oh my goodness, is this cool? Right? Isn't that cute? Our sons. Oh man, both of them. Hear a lot of cicadas going on. Where's Karen? Oh, there she is. Wild animal coming up. Oh, that's like really trippy.
Okay, that's tripping me out.
You notice there's like a grave by itself over there.
Like over there in the spirit box?
I'm not drawn over here, but.
Did you hear that?
We just got whistled. And that's not your phone.
No, because I put my phone on at my phone.
Well, we were walking over here. I heard something talking over here. Earlier. I think we got out of town.
Oh, it's the chain right there. I'm like,
yeah.
But then I noticed there's a flag and a chain.
Yeah. I like it. I think it was a dog. Is there help of him on there? Is your dog? Are there wolves? Coyotes.
Coyotes have more of them.
Yeah, they do. I don't know. They come in my neighborhood. It's weird because it's like, I don't know, maybe I'm hearing things.
Yeah.
But with my camera, it just brings out the light.
Heck.
Look. You see?
Right?
It's amazing. I like that. Whoa. I didn't touch on my whole, my back.
have to go back to that grave.
You do?
Yeah.
You want to eat the spirit box?
No, it's okay. I got one. I can have mine really close.
Okay.
Okay. This grave by itself is like calling me, so I'm gonna have to go over here. Like out of the whole cemetery. Right here by itself. Railroad ties. Spirits. Is there anyone here who wants to communicate with us? My name is Emmie. What's your name? You know, you can go ahead and come over here and talk into this device. I may not hear you right away, but when I go back over the footage, I will. What's your name? How you doing? Do you like the cemetery? Good to come visit you. What's your name again? Don't be afraid. You come with peace, love, and light. for a lot of babies buried here, isn't there? Can you tell me your name once more, please? Get the rain pot out. Just go ahead and see if there's anyone that wants to come around and communicate with us. Through the rain pot. Hi, my name is Emmie. Is there anybody here that wants to communicate with us? I come with peace, love, and light. What's your name? Come up and touch this rim pot. Make it go off, it won't hurt you. See? show me that you're here. Do you get many visitors? What's your name? Hi, I hear you trying to talk. What's your name? My name is Emmie. My name is Emmie. What's your name? Your spirits are with us. Can you come over and touch this device? Let me know that you're here. Thank you. Don't be afraid. I just came here to find out about you. Talk to you. This is Emmie with PDX Paranormal, and we are in Rosewood, Florida. This is where the massacre was. Racial violence erupted in the small, quiet Rosewood community January 1st to the 7th, 1923. Rosewood, a predominantly colored community, was home to the Bradley, Carrier, Carter Coins, and the Hall families. Among other residents, supported a school taught by Mahalda Gussie Brown Carrier, three churches, and the Masonic Lodge. Many of them owned their own homes. Some were business owners, and others worked in a nearby summer at the Cummer Lumber Mill. This quiet life came to an end on January 1st, 1923, when a white Sumner woman accused a black man of assaulting her. In the search for her alleged attacker, whites terrorized and killed Rosewood residents. In the days of fear and the violence that followed, many Rosewood citizens sought refuge in the nearby woods. Wright merchant John M. Wright and other courageous whites sheltered some of the fleeing men, women, and children. Whites burned Rosewood and looted livestock and property. Two were killed while attacking a home. Five blacks also lost their lives in Sam Carter, who was tortured for information and shot to death on January 1st. Sarah Carrier, Lexi Gordon, James Carrier, and Mingo Williams. Those who survived were forever scared or scarred. Continue on your side. Haunted by what had happened, those residents took a vow of silence, leaving the fear to acclaim the property. That silence was broken 71 years later, in 1994, survivors including Minnie Lee Langley, Arnett Turner Goins, and Wilson Hall filed a claims bill in Florida legislation. A special master and expert appointed by the Speaker of the House ruled that the state had a moral obligation to compensate survivors for the loss of the property, violation and constitutional rights, and the mental anguish. On May 4th, 1994, Governor Lawton Chiles signed a $2.1 million compensation bill. Nine survivors received $150,000 each for mental anguish, and the State University Scholarship Fund was established for the families of Rosewood and their descendants. A fund was also established to compensate those Rosewood families who could demonstrate property loss. This historic marker was dedicated by the Governor Jeb Bush in May 2004. That is, you know what? Oh, what's this say? Black Lives Matter. But you know, the thing though with the Black Lives Matter, that's emotion too for white and black, you know, because of what happens with the police.
Yeah. It really
sad what happened. It just makes me sick.
Yep. You want to step up there on the trail? That electric fence. But people put in hanging beads and stuff. It's so cool. Oh, angels and stuff have dropped. Oh, here's another mask. Because it's scared. Did it? Go get in the car, come on. Get in the car.
Thank you.
Back at the Shiloh Cemetery. And Patty caught some good stuff in it last night, so that's why we're back. We're going to check it out. Hope you enjoy the adventure. Who are you feeling, Patty? Where was that at?
Bad yet. I'm trying to figure it out. This was the Ford family was on that sign too, I remember. And the Weeks family is a Weeks baby over there.
Okay.
Looking for some names.
So, why are we back here again today, right now?
Because in my footage of, well, some pictures that I took when we were here last night, caught something very strange on camera, which I'll give Emmie the picture so you can put it in
with
the
this
video.
Insert with this.
It looked like a person standing there with an axe or something in their hand. It was so vivid, and I showed it to a friend of mine that is a demonologist, and he said it's a demon.
And also
didn't
looked
feel
like
right when we left here.
Also, on the other hand, it almost looks like a head.
Yes, you can see a face.
It's not good. Oh, no. I'm getting a headache on the side of my head right here.
Are you? These are all people from that massacre.
The massacre where we were just at, right?
Yes.
Yeah. A lot of them unmarked. No names. This is really, really sad, people.
Okay, so we're back at the cemetery, and it's the next day. And the reason we came back was because a photo that I caught here appears to be with some demons standing there. I showed it to a friend of mine that's a demonologist, and he said, yes.
Is this it? No, that's a cross.
Yeah, that's a cross. That's not it.
I thought you were like facing like that. Grave by itself over there too. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a bench.
We saw a face over here in a picture last night. Looked like a man standing here.
What's your name? I can see a name on a headstone.
REM pod. It's sitting on that bench. Let us know that you're here.
We bring peace, love, and light.
Yeah, we just visited the site where the massacre took place. We're so sorry for what happened to you guys. It wasn't right at all. Literally makes us sick.
What?
No. You scared me. What is it?
Roy Delbert. Delbert is the name, one of the names on the massacre site.
Was it?
I believe so. Yeah. Something similar to it. If
no,
that wasn't it.
The massacre happened in 1906, didn't it? Or 7. What was it?
It was January 1st to January 7th.
Could have been a family member, though.
That's what I'm wondering. That's really weird.
This is beautiful. It's weird. I'm gonna walk over here for a minute.
Yes. you tell us your name?
Me.
You hear that?